Subhra Saxena. I am consultant pediatric gastroenterologist and hepatologist at Manipal Hospital, Dwarka. And today I am going to talk about a very common condition, vomiting in children and babies. As you know, that occasional vomiting is quite common in children and babies, and usually they get better on their own within 24 to 48 hours. Now, if your child is persistently vomiting, then that is something you are really, really worried about. Now, there could be various reasons or causes wherein your child can have vomiting. So, let's look at them one by one. The most common cause of vomiting in children is gastroenteritis, as in common language we call them a stomach bug or stomach flu. Usually, it gets better on its own within 24 to 48 hours. You will see sometimes whenever you know, when you say in common language, oh, my child has got tummy upset, the child may be vomiting or the child may be have associated diarrhea or loose motion. And when you rehydrate the child gets better or tends to feel better within 24 to 48 hours. But sometimes this vomiting is persistent and it can be associated with severe signs or symptoms, like the child may be having fever or the child may look very, very distressed or the child may be drowsy. Then again, it is very important to remember that this can be a sign of some severe infection, which could be a brain infection, a chest infection or an ear infection or a simple urine infection. So these are something you should remember by. Then there are other common and important causes which are on a rise, like food allergies. Food allergies are becoming very, very common in children, and these are one of the reasons wherein child can have persistent vomiting, or the child can have single vomiting in days over a prolonged period of time. So sometimes what happens if a child is allergic to a food, the child will immediately react to it, like the child will have persistent vomiting, and there could be accompanied, you know, facial itchiness or rash or redness of the eyes or swelling around the lips. So you know that the child must be allergic to a particular food. Or it can be a prolonged allergy in which the child could be persistently vomiting over a period of days. So that is something which is important to remember. Secondly, if your child is very severely constipated, so you can see that the child has been complaining of tummy pain for a few days, and then suddenly, you know, the child has started to vomit probably once in each day. The vomit can happen any time of the day, you know. Mostly these kids are more nauseous during the early morning because they are not able to feel fresh. So, you know, they may have early morning nausea or vomiting. So that is again a very important cause which is becoming important nowadays. Thirdly, reflux or peptic ulcer disease, which we used to think that it is a disease of adults, has now become very, very common in children, especially the teenagers and adolescents. More so because they have now a different kind of lifestyle. They have more sedentary lifestyle. They are spending more time on their tabs. Their habit of eating junk food. You'll see that during nowadays exams are going on, the stress level of students are very, very high. Their sleeping patterns is completely disturbed. So because of that also, they might have increased incidence of reflux or vomiting or nausea. So that is something again which needs to be looked at, can be treated. And then there are other common or other causes which could be surgical causes in children, like, you know, the child may have appendicitis, but in that usually there will be vomiting with severe abdo pain, the child may have fever or child may be drowsy, you know. In that case, obviously you have to immediately rush to the hospital. Then there are other less common causes like eating disorders or cyclic vomiting, which is common in children. Now let's look at the common causes of vomiting in babies. Again, gastroenteritis as seen in children is also common in babies as well. They may have a stomach flu sometimes, and usually babies along with vomiting, they may have diarrhea. But again, with rehydration, babies tends to get better. In that case, you have to ensure that, you know, if you're breastfeeding, you continue to breastfeed, or if you're, you know, giving bottle feed, then you continue to bottle feed as much as the child is able to tolerate. Reflux is extremely common in babies, but most of the physiological reflux or the normal reflux that we know, they usually outgrow them by 6 months of age. But if the vomiting are persisting after 6 months of age in babies, then it's very, very important to seek a specialist advice. Then there are some surgical causes in babies. There could be some stomach condition like, you know, pyloric stenosis or other surgical condition which can lead to persistent vomiting at a very early age that needs again a specialist advice. So now what do we do? How do we care for our child at home while the child is vomiting? So obviously initially if you are suspecting any kind of, you know, mild stomach upset, you ensure that your child is hydrated by means of giving them, you know, simple clear liquids. The liquid can be oral rehydration solution. Nowadays all these oral rehydration solution are available in Tetra Pak as well, so kids prefer that as compared to the previous ones. Then secondly, you can give them other clear fluids like coconut water or buttermilk, whatever the child tolerates, and don't force them to drink excessively. Give them sip by sip but at frequent intervals. If it's a baby, then make sure that you are feeding the baby regularly or, you know, giving food regularly. Don't force the child to eat food. If the child has an appetite, you can offer solid food, but if the child doesn't want to eat, then just make sure that the child is adequately hydrated. It's important to remember some of the danger signs. So if your child is vomiting persistently, the vomiting is not getting better in 24 to 48 hours, there are other associated signs and symptoms like fever, or your child is really drowsy, or complaining of severe tummy pain, or, you know, headache, or if the color of the vomiting is green or blood stain, or the child is not passing adequate amount of urine, or the babies are not having enough wet nappies, then you have to remember that you have to quickly rush to the nearby hospital for an expert advice.